Dear students, you are welcome to the knowledge series on the new segment of fuzzy logic. This chapter, with respect to the fuzzy logic, we will be covering under several subsections. So a video series with respect to the fuzzy logic will be a continuation with respect to several subsection flow. We will see these slides and I will explain to you every content of this particular slides which has been shown over here. Fuzzy logic offers a self-computing paradigm. Self-computing paradigm means, if you want to understand the fuzzy logic, just me give a brief highlights about a term crisp logic or a crisp set. If you see over here a term fuzzy set and a crisp set are a part of a distinct set theories, where a fuzzy set implements infinite valued logic and crisp set employed bivalued logic. This is a very important terms. Let's take this figure. On the one side of the right side, you can see a figure with a sharp edge, whereas on the left side of the figure, there is a same object, but it is having a blunt, or the edge is having a shades. Now when we see this crisp set, it is something like an example, like a very strict mode of following the rules and patterns, where you should produce a particular figures in the form of a sharp edge, or you can say that a military style of functioning. On the other hand, if you see a figure which does not look for a very sharp edge, whereas just like a rough edge figures, or we can consider that this is not like a military styles, but just like a normal person who or a normal people who don't come into the form of a high strict discipline. So the crisp set and the fuzzy set, if you want to distinguish in another perspective, you can see that if a crisp set will normally define the logic in terms of two values, either in terms of a 0 or a 1, that is the term that is a bivalued logic, either 0 or 1. But when you talk about a fuzzy set, there is an infinite valued logic. Infinite valued logic means you cannot take a decision with respect to yes or no, or a 0 or a 1. Rather, we have to say that it is having a closest value, or it is nearly closer to a terms. So that's why, instead of saying 0 or a 1 in the fuzzy set, we say 0 to 1. That is the way we distinguish the fuzzy set. Hence, this crisp set and fuzzy set gives an idea. Thereby, Dr. Lotif Askarali Zadeh, he is the father of the fuzzy set theory. He developed the idea that any systems or a computational systems no need to have a exact numerical value. Rather, they can have a value which is having an approximations, or the value which may be uncertain, that can able to lead to a problem solutions. So that's why this fuzzy set is different as compared to the crisp set. Now let's go back to the slides. Fuzzy set means difficult to perceive, indistinct or unclear. That's why in the case of a fuzzy set, as the figure I have shown over here, that it talks about the figure in the form of unclear or imprecise or indistinct. What the logic means? Logic means a reasoning conducted or assessed according to the strict principle of validity. That's what I'm telling. I given to you is that that in the defense life working style structures, it is very strict. As an example, I am considering. So logical means reasoning conducted or assessed according to the reasoning conducted or assessed according to the principle of validity. Fuzzy logic is a mathematical language to express the real world problem to find the accurate solutions. Here the mathematical language is nothing but it's a set theory. So this set has to be defined. In the set theory, we are having a two contents. One is x parameters, another is a y parameters. The x parameter is the set of the crisp value. Corresponding to the crisp value, what are the membership values? So that has been that is denoted across the y. So the relations between the x and y will determines the fuzzy logic conditions. So that's why it's a mathematical language to express the real world problem to get the desired or accurate solutions. The real world problem is complex and uncertain in the form of ambiguity, because in the real world problem we cannot able to say anything in a precise way. Assume that a rainfall to occurs. You cannot say that the rainfall is going to occurs at a given hour, given minute, given second. Rather, you can say that the rainfall may occurs maybe in the evening or in the morning or maybe an hour like that. So a rough way, or in a linguistic terms or in ambiguity way, you can able to say. The mathematical language for communication has a grammar, syntax and semantic. So these are the terms, mathematical language, this grammar, syntax and semantics. It is being used when we try to come across the term like inference systems. So there we will try to learn more about these mathematical terms to know exactly what this fuzzy logic has to do with this mathematical language. Ambiguity means a quality of being open to more than one interpretations. So as I shown to you in the previous figure, is that if this particular crisp form of a object, if you view from the fuzzy set, you cannot able to say a exact object. Rather, you can say a just like approximations. So that's why the ambiguity of terming this particular object has a more than one interpretations. You can say this particular figures in a different form of interpretations. And on the other end, when you come to the word uncertainty, uncertainty means unpredictability or unreliable. So that's why you are not certain about that particular object. So that's why Dr. Zede applied this particular fuzzy logic to solve the any uncertain situations or a particular conditions which is a very much ambiguous and it will be having a more than one interpretation. That type of conditions that Dr. Zede used to Zede felt that okay, why not to use this particular situations to solve a complex conditions or a complex models. So that's why fuzzy logic was the real development, and it has brought a drastic change in the field of the modern systems. Now let's see the further expression. There are some form of a mathematical language: rational algebra, Boolean algebra, predicated algebra. Rational algebra means anything less than greater, say 2 is less than 4, 4 is greater than 3. So these thing type of terms we are using as a rational algebra. Why we are using this one? Because there are sets, that is we are terming a crisp set. So this crisp set has to convert into a membership functions. What is that one? We will see later part. So there we have to apply this particular like that several membership functions will be created. So there we have to apply this set theory based on the rational algebra. The second part is in the digital electronics. We can see that the Boolean algebra, these particular terms, like AND functions, NOT functions, sorry, OR function. AND is nothing but a conjunction. OR is nothing but a disjunctions. NOT is nothing but a negation. AND set, the OR set, or the NOT set. NOT is the opposite of a given set. And you are doing the AND operation between the two set, OR operations between the two set as a whole you take, or here you take the common which is among the two sets. So this is known as a Boolean algebra. Now next is a predicated algebra. Predicated algebra is the one where we can use the word proportional logic. So that's what I told you when we talk about the inference and other part of the things. This particular proportional logic will talk. So these are the operations is well formed for the formula. So here we will have a more clarity about this particular mathematical functions. Fuzzy logic deals with fuzzy sets or a fuzzy algebra. That is a vagueness or imprecise. So vagueness means which is uncontrolled, and imprecise means not achievable. So if a fuzzy logic is dealing with a particular set where the vagueness is there, uncontrolled form of a set is there, or the accuracy is one of the constraints. So the fuzzy logic is use this particular form of a sets to deal with the so that it can able to produce a desired output based on the vagueness or imprecise conditions. Fuzzy logic was introduced way back in 1965 by Lotif Asgerzadeh, and it is a mathematical tool to deal with uncertainty. So this is the whole idea in brief with respect to the fuzzy logic. The more about it we will understand in the subsequent sets of video series. With this, I conclude here. Thank you.